putting together a special Thanksgiving video. And also, if you've not done a leak on our grateful living wall, please do so. In that hole, there's marker and there's leaves in there. So you can do that and you can pin them on. I hope everybody got a chance to see the video, our Thanksgiving video for Ron Armstrong. I said it was, I thought it was really nice. And big shout out to this guy again here. You have learned how to do that. New software. Guided by Kurt, who also helped us. Big kudos to him as we are meeting mics and all kinds of stuff with bad back and everything. And Dave, and then there's, and then your friend Matt. So, plus there's a lot of others, but I thought they hadn't been around and wouldn't have gotten us. I said that, so thank you for that. This week, tomorrow night, NAMI, that remember it's meeting virtually. We have on the, there's a sign on the door that has the phone number for NAMI that they can call and register. It's on virtual. So, Christian Ed will also be tomorrow night at 6:30. Don't forget the Lions Club will be here on Tuesday meeting in the evening. Bells and Praise Team and Choir on Wednesday, Thursday. The Blue Kangaroo will be here this week. Next Sunday, we are having our after worship. There's a Friendsgiving with the youth. That everybody not going on that youth Friendsgiving, we hope to help us decorate for Christmas. We're not going to do as big as we had, concentrating on a few distinct areas, but if you can help us. The theme is, I believe, even when, fill the night with music and light. If you have some lanterns that you would allow us to borrow, bring those. We're going to use lights and lanterns and candles in the Christmas candles in our cabinet upstairs. So if you have some Christmas candles, decorative or whatever, we're going to use those. And that's about all I have come up with. So any, who wants to speak about the gratitude?
Just to go around all of these beds up here, we'll add a blessing when for our prayer time, but all of you here have a bag up here. So after worship, if you'll come up and find your name on a bag, and there's probably twice as many bags as people here. So that means if you know of any of these people that are maybe on your way home, on your scenic route home, on your long way home, or if you can deliver tomorrow since there's fresh duties, we want them to stay fresh. But if you'll take an extra bag, one of the other bags with the name on, and take it to that person, we'd appreciate it. And any bags that are left, we'll make sure that they get delivered. But if you can help and take a bag, that'll be awesome. Plus your own.
We sold 75. Last year we ever sold.
Wow.
And I was telling Kay out there, the last time we had this, it's left over from another event, and I used every one. This time I used all but two.
Oh my goodness.
And I ate one, so there's one of them.
We decided to cancel quilters just because of our
Are there any other announcements? All right then, and I'll close with this. Look back and be grateful. Look ahead and be hopeful. Look around and be helpful. Let us pray. Pray our worship.
Thank you.
In the midst of sickness and turmoil and uncertainty, we are still grateful for blessings from God.
To all celebrations, things that are blessed, and challenging situations, we will march together in grateful living.
You may be seated. So, does anybody, does anybody remember the key word from this week's jam time? I remember. It's talk. Because we talk to God. We also talk to each other. So today, I'm going on a little journey. And I'm not sure really what to take. So I thought I need to talk to people and see what I might need on my journey. So far, I have. I have a hat. I thought I'm going to leave that on the journey because it's supposed to be windy today. And I have. Two band-aids. In case I get hurt, I have two band-aids. What else do you think I might need on my journey?
Water.
Yeah. Bring. Something to sleep in, like a tent and a sleeping bag. A pillow? Is that what you said? A coat. Probably need a coat with my hat on. Yeah. Anything else we need? What do you think? If I'm going to take a hike up a mountain, up a hill. Yeah. Food. Need some food. Bring anything. A little heater. A walking stick. A compass, might need a compass or a map or maybe some guidance. So here's the thing, like I can ask you all and you can tell me what I need on my hike to the up the hill, but some things, isn't it better? What do you think, right? What else do I need? I mean Carter. A grappling hook in case I have to go up a cliff or the mountain gets rock with me. Anything else? Fishing pole, so I can catch my own fish. Yeah. Something to light a fire or cook with. So I can ask you, and you all can tell me, and I can fit it all in my backpack, and I can start out on my hike. And what I might need most is somebody to go with me. That might be really helpful. See, sometimes we need to talk to each other, we need to talk to God, so that God can help us and other people can help us. And sometimes we need somebody to go with us. We know that God walks with us, is with us all the time, but sometimes we need that person. And so this week, I want you guys to think about maybe somebody who needs help that might need you to kind of walk with them on in something that they may need help with. And we're thankful that God is there to walk with us and that we can walk with others who need our help. So I didn't pick a particular picture, but we're going to talk about a battle. So if you really get inspired, you can do a Lego battle scene. Or you might want to do something that you'd like to do with someone else. Because we're talking about marching together. So something you like to do with someone else. Okay? So think about that. So if you'll join with me in prayer. Dear God, thank you for walking with me.
Thank you for walking with me.
To school.
When I
play. And wherever I go. Thank you for others.
Who also walk with me.
Who also walk with me. because I knew the word. Those who are able, please stand and join me in our prayer of confession. Let us pray. God, like the Israelites, we too sin. We do what we shouldn't do. We don't do what we shouldn't do. We don't follow the way of Christ. Instead, we follow others or go our own way, leaving our faith behind. We ask for forgiveness. In Jesus' name, amen. Sin can divide. Love can unite. Jesus forgives us and offers us a vision of all.
As forgiven and forgiving people, we march together with Christ. Amen.
God, we come to you with gratitude, with grateful hearts, for the many blessings that we experience each and every day. We are thankful for the wonderful memories we have with family and friends and things that we've done in our own lives. For we know that during those times you were with us. And we are thankful that we are not alone on this journey of life, but that you are with us. For now, as this weather has been changing, sometimes almost daily, and warm and cold, and windy and rainy and then sunny, there are so many changes otherwise going on around too. But may you continue to blow the wind of your Holy Spirit in and through us. Lead us, guide us. Show us the way. We pray for those that we have mentioned today who are in need, for those who are battling with cancer in their treatments and in their healing, and for the families and friends along the way. We lift them up. For all of those nursing care or care places, assisted living apartments with our seniors in that are experiencing the COVID, we lift up the staff as they begin new things to deal with it, to keep people safe. We pray for our schools and teachers as students are now, many students are now going back online. And so many students who are being left behind in the education system because they're unable to learn in that way. So we lift them up. We pray for those who have been recently diagnosed with illness. Bring healing to their body, healing to their soul. For those that have lost a loved one, we pray for them that you would bring comfort to them, and we lift up them and their families and friends as they grieve. We give thanks for the joys of life, of new birth, of a new baby, the joys of being together, whether it be in, even in the midst of being socially distanced and wearing masks, that we can still be around people in safe ways, and when we feel we can, that there are other ways that we can communicate. For God, you have given us an abundance of technology, and we are thankful for that, especially at this time. We pray for our country, we pray for our world, and we give thanks for Jesus Christ in the midst of it, to continue to teach us and to continue to show us the way. We pray now as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation.
judge. Not really. I mean, you know, there's all kind of court judges, that's good, right? There's the criminal court, of course, and civil court, or juvenile court, or even the Supreme Court. Well, how about other kind of judges? Would anybody like to judge a beauty contest? I mean, doesn't that sound like fun? Okay, how about, chorus concert, or chorus contest, or band contest. That might be more fun, right? Yes. How about a gymnastic, the pie contest would be the worst one. Gymnastic contest? Yeah, the baking, obviously you're baking your pies, that's gotta be the most fun. Any other contest, okay, that you would like to judge? Cindy would like pies. It's hard to be a judge, I think. Although we do find ourselves from time to time judging people, each other, even though Jesus said, as we learned growing up, do not judge lest ye be judged, for God will judge you in the same way that you judge others. But there were judges in the Bible. So do you want to guess where in the Bible we find the most judges? In the book of Judges, yeah. Gosh, that is smart. Yes, that's exactly where we find the most of them. And so what the Bible judges did, it's a couple things, but it seemed like after God brought the Israelites from slavery to the promised land, I like to say that the Israelites lived happily ever after, but they didn't. Because it seemed to be that when the plight of the Israelite story is just this ongoing journey of them being faithful to God, and then when things are going good, and they kind of forget about God, and then somebody comes in to conquer them, and then lo and behold, a judge would get an army, and they would conquer the other guys, and then the Israelites would be free again, and they would be led back to God, and praise God, and everything would be good again. And then the cycle would continue. But the judges were part of that in leading the people to something better. There were 12 judges in the book of Judges. There weren't judges in the Bible, but 12 in the book of Judges. And I'm going to try to read their names. Othniel, Ehud, Shamgar, Deborah, Gideon, Korah, Jer, Jephthah, Ibzion, Elon, Abdon, and Samson. How about that for judges? Today, not just because I can pronounce the name, we're going to learn about Deborah. I can say her name. Good thing. She happens to be the only female judge recorded in the Bible. And so we're going to read from Judges 4, and I have a spoiler alert. There are some challenging words in the scriptures today. Just do your best with them like I just did the best with me reading the Judges. So we're going to start with, verse 1. After Ehud died, the people of Israel sinned against the Lord again.
So the Lord let them be.
The commander of the army was Sisera, who lived at Harosheth of the Gentiles. Then the people of Israel cried out to the Lord for help. Between Ramah and Bethel in the hill country of Ephraim, and the people of Israel would go there 15, 5 through 7, what judges, another role of the judges. Then God appointed judges in each of the fortified cities of Judah and instructed them, be careful in pronouncing judgment, for you are not acting on human authority, but on the authority of the Lord. And God is with you when you pass sentence. Honor the Lord and act carefully, because the Lord of God does not tolerate fraud or partiality or taking of bribes. So you see, the judges in biblical time, yes, they were there in bad times, but they were also had a huge responsibility of sitting under a nice tree and having people come with their problems and concerns and being able to make a judgment for them or give them advice on how to deal with certain things. Deborah was a judge for 40 years. So I think she must have been a pretty good judge. Let's hope so. We're going to read about one of her experiences now as I continue on in Judges 4. One day, Deborah sent for Barak, son of Abinoam, from the city of Kadesh in Naphtali, and said to him, the Lord, the God of Israel, has given you this command. Take 10,000 men from the tribes of Naphtali and Zebulun, and lead them to Mount Tabor. And I will bring Sisera, the commander of Jabin's army, to fight you at the Kishon River. He will have his chariots and soldiers, but I will give you victory over him. Very. Andrew Carnegie said teamwork is the ability to work together toward a common vision. The ability to direct individual accomplishments towards organizational objectives. It is the fuel that allows common people to attain uncommon results. H.E. Luckow said, no one can whistle a symphony. It takes a whole orchestra to play it. Charles Darwin said, it is the long history of humankind, and animal kind too, that those who learn to collaborate and improvise most effectively have prevailed. George Shinn said, there's no such thing as a self-made man or woman. You will reach your goals only with the help of others. So now back to Barrick. Barrick said, Deborah, I'll go if you go with me. I won't go if you won't go with me. Was Barrick weak? I don't think so. I don't know. Maybe he was. And if so, if Barrick was weak, we can learn how God used the weak and to become strong. When we're feeling weak, God helps us to find those who can march together with us. And we don't have to go it alone. Grateful living is seeing those who need someone to march with them and joining them along and helping them. We can try to do everything ourselves, and struggle along the way, but we can admit help, that we need help and march together to win the battle, to reach our goal, or to practice grateful living. Michael Rogers shares a story about a team leader trying to bring together a group of independent workers who were not getting much done together by themselves. So she asked each person to pick up a balloon and blow it up. So they all did, and they would write their name on the balloon. So they did that. So they got out of the room, come back in. And when they came back in, there were like hundreds of balloons. If you imagine in here, hundreds of balloons. And the people were to go in, there were about 20 to 30 people in there. They were going in and find the balloon with their own name on it. And trying to break any other balloons in the process. Well, 15 minutes went by and no one had found their own balloon. So she sent them to the leader, she sent them all back out again. They came back in and she said, okay, now this time we're going to try something differently. You come in, and she said, the first balloon you find with a name on, you hold it up, call it out, and give it to the person whose balloon it is. Within 5 minutes, everybody had their own balloon. Reminds us of when we work together, when we march together, we can be much more efficient and get things done. See, Barrick knew that God was with him. He also seemed to know that he would be stronger marching together with another person of God by his side. Sometimes we'd rather do things by ourselves because, well, we can be in control, right? We can do things the way we want them to be done. And we can make all the decisions, and at the end, we can get all the credit for what was done. Well, grateful living is marching together. It is the couple struggling in their relationship that goes to counseling to work things out rather than walking away from years of love. It's people walking together in relationships amidst disagreements. It's the Virginia Military Institute cadets who were called to the Battle of Newmarket when they were told to retreat. They stood and marched together with the other soldiers and fought along beside them. It's all of the military units today that march together on their assignments and have each other's backs. Marching together is all the neighbors on Little House on the Prairie who see and join in the injured paw and join with young Laura and Mary to help stack the heavy bags of grain up in a pile by the evening so that Paul can pay for the oxens that he desperately needs. It's neighbors everywhere marching together, helping others. Grateful Living is marching together with all the families, friends, and caregivers, staying by the side of loved ones who are battling cancer or COVID or long-term illnesses. It's the teachers marching together with the students as they go back and forth from in-person to online learning and back again. It's all of us marching together, sharing the love and concern and supporting one another. Taking gratitude bags to people. The road may be difficult, and we will laugh and we will cry, but we will continue on in the battle and marching together. So Deborah and Barrett marched together. Barrett led the army to victory. And I bet you want to know the rest of the story, right? It's a good one. So Deborah said to Barrett, when they got to the hill, army down there, his army up here, she said, "Go, for the Lord is leading you. Today he's giving you victory over Sisera." So Barrett and his 10,000 went down the hill, and Sisera's whole army, they got killed. Sorry. Victory. But Sisera lived. He didn't stay marching together with his men and animals. He fled. He took off. So he got to the house of Jael, the wife of Hebar the Kenite. And she went out to meet him and said to him, "Hey, come on in, sir. Come into my tent. Don't be afraid." So he went in. She offered him food. She offered him drink. He got tired. She offered him a place to sleep. And then she took a hammer and a tent peg and quietly went up to him and drove the peg right through his hand. And now you know the rest of the story. I like to say I made this all up, but it's straight from the Bible. Judges chapter 4, if you want to check it out. Oftentimes, that's why we don't read the rest of the story in the Bible. Because the endings aren't quite like we expect or think they ought to be. Maybe the moral of the story is Sisera should have stayed with his company and at least died with them. However, now you know the rest of the story. Back to Grateful Living. Marching together is all of us who haven't given up reaching out as a church because of COVID. We've opened our minds to listen to God leading us in new directions. We are marching together as people of God with Jesus by our sides. We are not alone. With so much going on around us in the world, in our community, in our country, may we all continue to follow Deborah and Barrett's example and make the commitment with each other and Jesus Christ to keep marching together, following where God leads us. protection for our offerings. Let us pray. God, with what you see before us, we demonstrate our deepest love. Receive our gifts, our very best, as sweet offerings before you. May they be a blessing to others that they have been for us. Amen.
Thank you.